it was really weird. Kung ang usapan natin ay season 2 lang, na-challenge ako kay Ward.
For me, season 2 is made up last.
Wow, okay.
Gulat ka. Made up last, di ba?
Interesting.
Okay. Papilayo, yen.
Oo nga pala, meron pa nga
pala. So I don't know why I was called there.
Sa mga hindi nakakalam sa mga viewers natin, welcome back sa The Guest List!
Hi guys! Hello!
Let's go! Let's go!
Pangatlong episode na natin to in just 2 days. Oh, grabe!
Hindi man lang kayo naligo. Oh. Yan pa rin suot nyo, Diyos ko naman.
Sa mga, ano ba to? Sa mga nakikinig sa Spotify.
We're very busy. And it can be twice a week.
So again, welcome to The Guest List. You're now watching us at Fairfax Network Channel. My name is JV Advincula.
I'm Ryan Tanyada.
And I'm John Herrera.
Ano nga ba ang continuation ng pinag-uusapan natin last time?
Uh-huh. Highlights.
Recap.
Last podcast natin, pinag-usapan natin sino ang favorite natin from season 1.
Again, yung favorite na yan, ha?
Bias yan.
Sasabihin bias, favorite bias. Ni Ryan si ano bias, kasi bias, may kumburus-kumburus-king ka na. Hindi naman pepe. Basta, yung favorite is the top 3 and may malalaman nyo naman. Diba?
Yeah.
Ano pa pinag-usapan natin?
Recruitment.
Kung hindi nyo napanood yun, kung sino yung favorite tsaka yung medyo sakit sa ulo para sa amin ng season 1, balikan nyo yung podcast namin before this para mas malaman nyo.
Exactly. Sino ba? Recruitment?
Recruitment. Who recruited who?
Oo. Exciting to. Mm-hmm. Yung mga idol nyo, malalaman nyo kung sino yung nag-recruit. Yeah.
This story. But JV, I think we're gonna do something different this season, di ba? We're gonna be recording behind the scene episodes.
Yeah. Yes.
Can we set that up first? Because we're part of the podcast is you wanna know the drama behind the drama. Yeah. We'll give you that, di ba?
Yes, kung napanood nyo ang The Last Dance ni Michael Jordan tsaka yung Fire Festival, yun ang bago ngayong Cycle 2. Mm-hmm. Hindi nyo lang makikita ang mga content creators nyo ng Cycle 2, kundi makikita nyo rin ang management, ang production team,
agency,
behind the scenes action, kung paano ba na-close ang deal na to, paano ba na-recruit to, sino bang napagalitan, sino ba ang finire. May ganun pala, joke lang. But abangan nyo yan, lalabas yan. Kung hindi kayo naka-subscribe dun sa YouTube channel na premium,
the juiciest, I think. It's the juiciest.
Yes. Kasi kami, hindi naman kami, we're just doing our job. Yeah. We would like to share what's happening inside, behind the scenes of the House of Collab. Lalo na ngayong Cycle 2.
Yes.
Yan.
Okay.
So, ready na ba kayong pag-usapan?
Diretsuin na natin.
So, the topic from season 1 now is season 2.
Okay, sige. Pag-usapan na si Jordan. Jordan, shout out sa'yo kung nanunood ka. Ay, hindi ba ganon? Hindi ba ganon?
Why is this so special? You said last time, season 2 is special. Why?
Yeah.
Okay, why?
Parang pumotok. Parang something happened.
According to sa mga nabasa ko, lagi pag sinasabi nila na season 2 hits different daw. Kasi sabi nila, season 2 parang wala masyadong issue.
All love teams.
Family friends, ganyan. And sabi mo rin kanina, we have the highest views in all platforms.
Correct.
Ng season 2. Projects everywhere whatsoever.
Oh, grabe.
The opportunities.
The gifts from the fans.
Yes. Yes.
Sa Italy, grabe. John, remember, every day.
Every day, flowers, pizza, donuts, phones.
Jordans, grabe.
Never.
Teddy bear.
Yeah.
Never lumagpas ang isang araw nang walang dumating sa mansion na any gift. Never dumaan ng isang araw na walang cake, walang donut at pizza sa loob ng mansion in a day.
That for me, opened my eyes. I go, this is something, we're doing something good.
Yeah.
And I wanna say, season 2, going to our recruitment strategy, I think 9 to 10 billion views that season.
Yeah.
That was like, wow.
Yeah.
10 billion views.
Yung na-reach natin?
Parang that we peaked.
No. Chinek namin yun after. We reached 13 billion.
With hashtag. I mean, documented.
Because you remember, you gave me a challenge noon. Patapos na yung season. It's 3 weeks before, naalala ko yun eh. Nasa 9 billion na kami. And then sabi ni John, before the, I need it to be 10 billion. Yeah, you remember that? Sabi ko sa'yo, considered done. Actually,
kasi walang inuurungan si Ryan Tanyada. Sabi nga ni Ryan Tanyada, like and follow.
Nakalike and follow ka. guys. So sabi ko, consider it done actually even more. Yeah. So after that, we check it.
Yeah. It's a game. You gamified it.
So exactly. Going back to John's point, paano ba nagsimula ang recruitment ng The House of Collab
Season 2? Yes.
Yan. And John was saying, we had a different strategy. Mm. John, can you share to us what changed from how we recruited from Season 1 to Season 2?
Diba, our perception for Season 1 is like, let's get... Mm.
Heavy hitter.
They're going to make it.
Yeah.
What we didn't realize, the heavy hitters weren't the hardest workers.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
So the work ethic. And there's a bit of a, I'm 10 million. Why do I got to do this?
Shout out sa season one.
Yeah, like, I don't want to do
this. Season one, sinabihan ng management, mag-IG reels. Yeah. Sir, ayoko kasi masira yung aesthetic.
I agree with him. Sir, like, whatever.
Ayoko, I don't like
it. Now everyone is posing IG reels.
Ngayon, lahat nag-aagawa. IG reels.
So the concept is, we're going to coach you to become more profitable. Of course, we're a marketing house, we're a business.
Mm-hmm.
And we would give you the best direction, not just for bullshit. So season 2 is like JV. It's like those movies. I want to get the wild cards, get the lowest of the low.
Yeah.
And we started recruiting anyone below 20,000.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Anyone below 20,000.
Sino ba ang mga ni-recruit mo? Nasaan na ba sila ngayon?
Yeah.
Pero mga juicy stuff. Ang dami natin season 2.
Sino ba? Wait lang. Check ko nga yung list natin ng season 2.
So, I think earlier you said Shaz, Telly, they're part of it.
Oh yeah.
Shaz, Telly.
At meron tayong, explain lang natin bakit sila bumalik ng season 2. We have what we call leaders.
Yeah.
Sila yung mga content creators from the past season, which is, I'm sure if you're a fan of the House of Collab, you're able to understand na meron tayong mga nagbabalik.
Yeah.
And yung mga reason ng mga pagbabalik ng mga yon is not because they lack exposure, but they're there to set an example and as a guide. Kasi katulad nga ng sinabi ni John in our past podcast, hindi naman kami ni John natutulog dun eh. Even the management don't sleep at the mansion. It's only Ryan that's really interacting with everybody and finding out what are the best ways to grow.
Yeah.
So, syempre, as we grow, ano ba yun? May nagtatawa na pa dun.
Violation ticket.
Guys, respeto naman dyan sa mga tatawanan, naririnig namin kayo.
Oy, may mga content creator dito. Gumagawa kami ng content. Oh. Oy,
violation ticket yan, ha? Anyway, mabalik tayo dun. Silang mga leaders are there to be...
Set the standard.
Set the standard.
Yeah.
And sino ba ang mga leaders natin nun, Ray?
We have Silly Noblesa. We have Shaz.
Park Support.
Yeah, we have Made the Plus. We have Mark, nag-start.
Bernardo.
Mark Bernardo. And then we have Leo. That's it. Yeah, and then me. Seven kami na.
Okay, 7. Yan, pag-usapan natin.
So who are the new ones again? Please refresh my memory.
Dami, bro.
Daan na natin lahat. Ako, sa mga naaalala ko ng season.
Yeah.
Ayoko pala mauna. Baka may sabihin, bakit una kong sinabi yung pangalan na yun? Twitter! Hello!
So we have Russell, Harsh Boy.
Yeah.
RC, ano ko ting?
Yeah.
No, RC is ano?
Season 3.
RC is Katok. Katok.
Yeah, Katok. Oh,
Katok. Yeah, she came in Katok.
And ito, ano ko, nasa IG ako.
Zyra.
Season 2, isa-isain ko, hindi in our particular order ako. Kuya Punch.
Depende kung sino unang finalo ni Ryan.
The House of Collab.
The House of Collab pa yan.
Okay, we have Kuya Punch, Celine, Mark Bros. Cherise, Chani, Ishi, Leo, Mahalia, Louis J, Ward, Bebe Dars, Yenny Lagman, Zaira Basco, AG, Harsh Boy, Dom Savares, Steph, Sweet, Jetro Alaban, Ana Koting, Sid, Telly, Carlimpin.
Paano pag nag-deactivate sila ng Instagram, di mo masama sila masasabi?
Hindi, meron dito naka-deactivate. Pero,
sino pa? Si Rodolph.
Rodolph.
Si Roji.
Roji.
Sino pa?
May. Bianca Mallorca.
Bianca Mallorca. Roby Dal.
Vendetta.
O yun, si Vendetta. Roby.
Ashley. Loyola.
Sino pa ba?
Yesang.
Ayun, si Yesang.
That's it?
They were at the pool party.
Yeah.
Those guys were at the pool party.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Because we already knew that they're going to come in. They walked in the stage.
Yeah.
Oo nga.
And we had a 15-day transition. Parang less than a month.
Yeah.
Parang that's it. Terry.
Terry
Lewis.
Batang 90s.
Batang 90s.
Oh, Jordan.
Casey.
Jordan.
Thank you sa pag-guesting mo.
Alinea.
Alinea.
That's it.
Okay. So the recruitment, according to John.
This is the real life story.
Ito ang totoong story niyan.
Real talk.
We opened our doors to non-heavy hitters.
Yes.
And the reason for that is, as John mentioned, ulitin ko lang at i-emphasize ko. Sometimes kasi, I'm not saying everyone of the heavy hitters are tamad or may ere. or entitled. Siguro, we opened our doors because we want to give chance to upcoming
new blood.
And it's really dun talaga nagsimula yung parang, what if we find someone that's wildcard, diba? Sa The House of Collab Season 2. So, to refresh your memory, the three of us were there. Saka LG room. LG room pa yun. Yeah. There was a big whiteboard.
Yeah, oh, yung sinusulat natin.
You know, for me, every season, that's the most exciting part kasi yeah, that will dictate the tempo and the success of each season ng The House of Collab.
Para tayong bumubuo ng ano, ng Avengers nga. X-Men.
Yes.
Thocverse.
Ano, parang ano, drafting. Ng,
yeah,
ano,
drafting, yeah. Drafting.
Favorite ko yan kasi nag-NBA ano ako eh. But, so that's the context. We opened our doors to potential new recruits.
Yeah.
So, ano ba ang storya nitong araw na to na nandun tayo sa LG room? Ewan ko, ako, I have a photo. I have a photo. Sige, while
in-story natin yun eh, photo na yun.
While I'm looking for the photo, pag-usapan nyo muna kung what do you recall?
I remember we weren't complete. Actually, some people couldn't confirm. We were having a hard time
to confirm.
The last minute.
Yeah.
This is the most memorable story. When he got Chani.
Yeah, Chani. Chani.
Just fast forward.
I already had some people on my list.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, history makes sense in reverse.
Yeah.
We have nothing to do with, we just felt something with choosing whoever we chose.
Yeah, we felt something talaga.
Just to set the record straight.
Yeah.
You know, Ward, of course, she's one of, you know, the biggest.
Yeah.
You know, she was actually not supposed to be in season two. She was the last minute. Like,
oh,
a filler.
Yeah. She was a filler. Yeah.
So when we talk about recruitment, you also got to talk about luck.
Yeah.
And intuition. And like, Chani goes, I have a friend. She's from a P-pop band.
Yeah, yeah.
She can dance. She can sing. And I looked at JV. I'm like, he's... I was like, oh yeah, sure, cool, like whatever. Like, I don't. We're willing to try anything.
Yeah.
Me naman, you know, I'm looking at people. I found Angge.
Yeah. Okay. But wait. Before that, what's your reaction nung sabi yung word?
Hindi. Wait lang ha. Hindi ko kasi mahanap yung. Hindi ako nagpe-pay attention sa usapan niyo. Yeah. Pero go lang. Hindi ko siya mahanap. So we'll wing
why,
it.
Why this is a very important story?
Yeah.
Because your last ones doesn't mean just because you're in last doesn't mean that you'll end last. And the wild card is we never thought about anything. There was no overthinking about it. Like, May was already considered a star.
Yeah.
And Celine was the biggest thing. At then, we're like, just put her in. And it's just like, whatever.
True. Ganito, himayin natin yan. Siyempre, pag nagsulat tayo sa board, we try to put in first everybody. This is how recruitment happens, guys. We'll explain to you. All of us...
Sit in a room.
And we talk about it. Who are your recruits? Mm-hmm. Who are your recruits? Who are your recruits? Casey, who are your recruits? Who are those who auditioned? We put them all sa whiteboard. After that, katabi nun... follower count.
Yeah.
And during these kinds of casting meetings, we go through each one of them. And then, that's the time, kung halimbawa, recruit ni John si Angge, that's his time to defend.
Thesis.
Bakit? And kami, inaano namin,
parang talaga siyang thesis.
Oh. Kasi, defend why?
Oh, yeah.
So, lahat kami nagkaroon ng chance to defend.
Yeah.
So, syempre, gusto mo, sa dami naman nun, bibigay na namin sa inyo kung anong gusto nyo. Kung sino gusto nyo pag-usapan, pag-uusapan na namin ngayon.
Yeah.
So, unahin na natin total in-open naman ni John. In my recollection, ang unang-unang pinasulat ni John is si Angge.
Yeah.
Bago pa man mag-start yung meeting, pinapakita niya sa akin yan. Bro, have you seen this girl?
she can do
POV, she's a flight attendant, and again, and I'm like, oh, nice. Sige, let's talk about it later. Ganun. Yeah. Kasi si John, ganun siya.
Yeah.
Marunong siya mang-hype.
Actually,
which is ganyan din yung ginawa niya kay SJ. Hinipe niya ng todo si SJ.
Tsaka it's a different conversation. Pende, ang maganda naman kay John, pagka nagsabi siya ng ano, tapos naging problem yung inano niya, ina-handle naman niya, ikaw bahala ka dyan, ikaw nagpahala mo yan, ikaw yun, sa iyan.
Kito lang sabihin ni John, pagka problem, pagka yung bata niya o yung recruit niya yung problema, sabihin lang niya, I don't wanna talk to him anymore. Casey, handle it. Ipapasa na ni John.
That's your problem.
James, nung...
Tapos magli-leave na group chat.
Sure.
Magli-leave na GC yan. I don't wanna talk about it. This is a waste of my time. Biglang, John Herrera left the chat.
JB, anong reaction mo nung unang pinakita ni John si Angge?
Okay, ito, honest reaction to all the viewers. And I'm ready for the bash.
Baby bash.
This is ano naman eh, pre-judgment.
Bago natin nakilala sila lahat.
And it's a big risk, ha? We were like, shit, this is a big risk.
Kasi I hope you guys understand, we're taking risk talaga pagka nagpapasok kami. Parang, what if it doesn't pan out? Hindi siya naging successful sa loob, di ba? Parang, syempre kami niisip iniisip namin, we could have put other people in there. Sayang slot. Parang ganun. Yes, so, kumbaga, pinag-uusapan na namin
sa dami na, sa libo ng, naniniwala ako, guys, kung hindi kayo naniniwala, libo talaga so, nag-audition. Yeah. Hindi lang kasi talaga lahat nakikita sa, yeah. ano, sa hashtag. Yeah. Kasi marami doon mali-mali yung hashtag.
Oh, double talk, double, oh, yeah. like, misspelling.
Yes, yes. So, honest reaction.
Angge.
Angge. So, yun ang hinahype talaga ni John bago pa mag-start yung meeting. Na parang, yeah. I found this girl, Angelica pang tawag ni, yeah. ni John. Eh. So, Angelica, have you seen this girl? Have you seen ganyan? Yeah. So, si Angge yung unang-unang pangalan na nandun sa board. Mm. So, syempre, kaka-start pa lang. Ang sabi ko, wait lang, balikan natin siya. Wait lang. Yeah. Okay, hindi muna guaranteed. Kasi, imagine mo, kapag sa contest or competition, kung sino yung una, may pros and cons. Eh. So, parang nasa isip mo, parang wait lang, baka meron pa. Eh, syempre, season 2 to, crucial, na we learn from our mistakes from season 1. So, ako mismo, sinabi ko, John, wait lang. Hold muna. So, I did not say no, but I said, wait lang for Angge. And then, sunod-sunod na yung mga pangalan.
Yeah.
So, as we go along, shortcut, si Angge, nag-agree pa kaming lahat onto the pa-closing na.
Yeah.
Dahil, in all fairness to John, when he believes in something, he pushes for it. Na, sa simula, pre-hype, pinupush niya. Nung nag-start na, pinupush na. Nung middle, binalik pa niya. Nung dulo, binalik pa ulit ni John.
Naalala ko, may isa pang pinupush si John nun eh.
Sino yan?
Yung, hindi ko pa siya.
I don't remember.
Sino si Erica Pineda?
No. We can talk about that later.
Nurse? No, you remember?
Yes.
Sabi pa ni Jan, pinupush niya, sabi niya.
Yung nurse.
Ryan, bagay kayo neto.
I forgot her name.
Ray.
Ray.
Yeah, I can't remember.
So, actually, that's true. Sa mga viewers, we're letting you know how we think, how we play around. And that's just proof na mayroong pinupush. John pushes everybody that he believes in. Pero hindi naman lahat nagfo-full on na magsasign. Yeah.
Pero yung angge, talaga namang ano, talagang John.
Right? Nice. That's actually a great recruitment. Yeah.
I have a jersey.
Yeah. Ato, ano si, ano, nung nakita ko yung si Angge. Kasi nakita ko na si Angge before. Nakita ko yung POV niya. So,
ito, tanungin kita. Kasi ako yung nilagay mo sa spot. Ano yung, ako, sinabi ko na explanation ko. Ryan, sabihin mo yung totoo nung nandun tayo. Nung,
sa LG room.
Sa LG room. Na kung ano yung naging reaction mo nung unang-una si Angge na nakalista doon. Na parang yes or no ba tayo dito? Or hold ba?
Ang, I remember, si Angge, tsaka hindi lang si Angge, may iba pang mga content creator. Parang we're very undecided pa sa kanila.
True.
So parang nilagay natin sila dun sa third column. Alam ko, column
yun, di ba? Hindi ko mahanap yung picture. Si Casey yata may picture na rin.
First column, yung sure na tayo. Second column, yung nakalimutan ko ano bang. Tapos third column, nandun sila. Parang nilagay natin sila dun. Parang,
for all the viewers, ano yung explanation nun? Nandun sila, unang nakasulat yung pangalan. Pero nung nag-decide kami na yes na sila, medyo latter part pa.
Yeah. Nung nakita ko si Angge, sabi ko, nakita ko na si Angge nag-POV, she's fun. Pero to be honest, nung nakita ko si Angge, sabi ko talaga, kasi kamukha talaga si Angge nung kapatid. When I saw her photo, talaga, hindi ko nakita na kamukha ko siya kasi naano naman ako mga kamukha pero nakita ko siya kamukha ng kapatid ko. Sabi ko, sige ba? Pero hindi talaga ako nakialam kay Angge. Kayong dalawa nag-usap nun eh.
Yes,
so,
yes.
Kay Angge, yung recruit mo, yung medyo may ano ako, may
sinabi ka.
Balikan natin. Balikan natin.
Pag-uusapan natin mamaya yan kung sino yung recruit ko na sinabi.
Recruit,
may sinabi ka. Sige. But in my understanding, Ryan was medyo on kami ni John, aligned na kami sa new format.
Yeah.
Si Ryan, aminin mo Ray, Ray was still pushing for heavy hitters.
Yes.
And ang number one pick,
Ray was like, why am I gonna be in the room with them?
Hindi naman ganun.
May 5 million followers.
There was like a stretch is like if you brought anyone under 100,000 you had to justify.
Para kay Ryan. Kailangan natin pagtanggol kay Ryan.
You had to sell him on the brand.
Ganun naman talaga. Tsaka I remember, naalala ko kasi doon. Naalala ko nung time na yun. Recruitment is really priority sa akin. When it comes to recruitment, that time, di ba? Pag nagbigay ako ng list, eto pasok na. Sure na to mga to.
Dapat ganun eh.
Oo, di ba? Parang ganun. Pag nagbigay ako ng list, eto sure na to. Tapos whatever, parang i-fill in nyo kung ano yung.
Yes, kami actually ni John, nung season 2 guys, sa lahat ng nanonood.
Backseat driver kami.
Ano kami, siya talaga driver ng bus. Kami, ano lang kami, pampuno.
Parang ganun.
Pampuno. So yung mga idol nyo, pampuno lang pala nung simula. Kasi si Ryan kasi, may mga pinupush nung simula. Diba? So, yun nga, I think ang top na pinupush ni Ryan was si Mahalia.
Yeah, Mahalia.
Yeah, tama ba si Mahalia?
Mahalia Charisse. Actually, chatting and...
Si Anna Kuting kasi, apprentice na siya.
Apprentice, yeah.
Bago pa... yung ikaw siguro, yeah. Syempre deciding ano para deciding factor. Pero it was really Mahalyaw is yeah, the number one. Mahalyaw. Number one pick ni Ryan. So, ganun ang nagiging ang story no. Katulad nga ng sinabi niya, nakasulat lahat ng heavy hitters. Heavy hitters again sa mga hindi nakapanood ng past episodes namin. Ang heavy hitters for us is yung mga malalaking followers.
Yeah.
Like 5 million up. Ganun yeah. talaga. So, going back, Ray, yung flow ng conversation natin. Marami namang hindi, I'm not saying everybody's just a filler.
Yeah.
And I think this season napatunayan yung concept na
yes.
ginawa natin na yes. when we opened it up to more lesser followers,
yeah.
dun pala talaga yung mga hard workers.
Yes, so, totoo.
Yan. So, during the recruitment, o ano, pag-usapan na natin. So, sino ba mga recruit natin na notable? Diba? So, ako, ang recruit ko noon was Chani.
Chani pa
Chani. Oh, Chani talaga. Chani.
That leads to?
Di bago, may story yan. May story yan.
Okay, okay.
So, napupuno na yung ako, eto talaga, talagang ang sabi ko, Chani will be my next superstar.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Sabi ko talaga, as in, kini-question ni John, kini-question ni Ryan, ay, ang baba ng followers. Sagot ko, oy, tignan mo yung Instagram, tignan mo yung Instagram. Si Ryan parang, ang konti ng post, ba't konti yung post?
Oo, oh, konti ng post.
Parang ganyan, sabi ko, akong bahala, si Chani, he will be the next, I mean, the boy next door.
Actually, hindi yun yung term mo sa akin, sabi mo sa akin nun, sabi, Ryan, antayin mo to ha. I have the, ano, ang term mo nun is, ano, what, meron akong wild card sa mga boys. Sabi niya, tignan mo, tatalunin na natin lahat ng lalaki. Sabi niya, si wild card? Si Chani. Naalala ko nun, sabi ni JV, pag yan nagla-live stream, minimum, ganito na ako.
Siyempre,
pag yan nagla-live.
Siyempre, kung may build-up kayo sa mga bata niyo, may build-up din ako sa mga bata ako na, sabi ko si Chani, sa ano, sa Bigo. Sa Bigo, million yan. Tapos, nung screen test, sa mga hindi nakakalam, ang screen test is, before season, pinapapunta na namin yung mga content creators sa mansion. Tapos, sinushoot namin sila. If they look good on camera, di ba? How they react, the how they look.
Talk,
kasi,
yeah.
alam naman natin, social media, napakadaming filter.
Filler.
So, we wanna see them in person.
Yeah.
So, yun na nga, hindi ko i-deny yung sinasabi ni Ryan. Ganun talaga ang build-up ko kay Chani. And I feel like why Chani's stint with season 2 and season 4 was short was maybe because iba pa rin ang focus ni Chani.
Yeah.
So, ganun talaga. Ito, first time, guys, naririnig nyo kung ano ba ang nasa utak ng mga utak talaga ng The House of Collab FEMI when we were starting this season.
Pero iba yung ano, para sa laking improvement ni Chani nung season 4. Kung yung mindset niya nung season 4 pagpasok niya nung start, ganun yung mindset niya nung season 2. It could have been different.
But that's the process.
Yeah.
That's
true.
It's like coming back to school.
True.
Yeah. Agree. So going back to that recruitment list. Yeah. So ito ang story niyan. So napag-usapan natin si Angge, napag-usapan natin si Mahalia. Diretso na tayo sa nung patapos na ang ano, baga, last two slots or last slot.
Mm-hmm.
Last slot left for season 2. Biglang may sinabi ako kay Casey. Casey, pasulat ako nitong ano, Reynaline Ward, 'di ba?
So Ward.
Syempre, time to me to explain kasi yeah. nung sinulat yung Reynaline Ward, dilabas kagad nila yung mga cellphone nila, which is we do it for everybody.
Yeah.
So, oh, ano to? 89K ba to? Or below 100K? Bakit? Tapos, ang explanation ko, guys, is, sabi ko, we need someone that touches this kind of crowd. Parang for me, parang, if I recall correctly, the party crowd.
Mm.
Kasi, when we look at that time, the stories of Ward sa kanyang IG, when we were researching.
Going out a lot.
He's going out a lot. You see him at, I don't know, Yes Please or Pobla.
Yeah.
So, I feel like, sabi ko, ito, magaling to. I didn't even know that Ward sings that time. Yeah. We didn't know.
No one knows. Yeah.
Actually, hindi ko rin nga alam na mayroon siyang girl group nung time na yun eh. Ang alam ko lang is ang galing niyang sumayaw and I said to them na kalimutan niyo na muna.
Is it good for brands?
It's good. Yes. Yes,
good, good for brands. Like, dude, pwede to sa Vans.
Oo, kasi for those who know, syempre partners natin sila. Guess, Vans, Dickies, all of those, The Rail, ganyan. She's perfect for it.
Mm.
Kasi girl siya, girl maganda, maputi. Tapos noon, can wear female
dress. Actually, that time hindi ko pa alam. Yeah. Hindi ko alam na ganun siya magdamit.
And can wear also ano streetwear.
Yeah.
So parang sabi ko, I mean, patapos na rin naman na yun, sabi ko, kalimutan na muna natin lahat ng nasa side, si Ward na yung last na ipasok natin.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, we had no prior interaction to Ward because the story for that is when I recruited Chani,
parang hinabulan na talaga si Ward.
She's plus one lang.
Ako talaga nag-recruit kay Chani, ako nakakita sa kanya at pinakausap ko sa, actually ako pa yung nag-message kay Chani. Ginamit ko yung The House of Collab na account. Sumagot siya, nung sumagot na siya, interested siya, pinasa ko na kay Casey. Nas gayon, Casey told me na merong friend si Chani, which is si Ward started nga, na marami rin naman silang, like for example, si Melly, noong season 1, Melly was referred by Tom. Tama, di ba? So, this is not the first time we've encountered this kind of thing. So, parang sa akin, sa dami rin ng mga ganyan, for some reason, sinabi ko, let's take Ward. Let's give the last spot for Ward, di ba? So, that's the recruitment, di ba? May tanong pa ba kayo?
What's your reaction nung pinresent niya si Ward sa atin?
Usually, I wasn't really resistant of anyone. The thing is, it's all about testing the pudding. It wasn't like, dude, it's over or it has begun. I go, let's see. It's always like, let's see. Because the first 4 weeks, they're just getting to know. But we can go into detail what happened in between.
Exactly.
Ako naman, I didn't say no naman to Ward. Pero alam mo naman, lagi akong critical eh. Tuwing may ano ganito, critical ako lagi na, I remember I asked you, James, are you sure? Kasi check ko yung, di ba, pagkasabi, check agad tayo ng ano. Of course, may unang titignan mo is yung mga nasa top na video, diba? So I was like, yun sabi mo nga, hindi ganun kataas yung followers. Sabi ko, she's a pretty face. So sabi ko, if we're looking for a pretty face, there's so many content creator with a pretty face with a higher following.
Kasi nga nung time na yun, si Ryan still on the heavy hitter side yung recruitment phase niya.
And I didn't know that time, sumasayaw at kumakanta si Ward. So I was thinking na parang, sorry to say, nung season 1, meron tayong mga content creator na maganda lang.
Sino ba to? Ganda lang,
different assets, different skill sets.
Maganda lang, tas hindi, they don't know how to create a content, tamad, may mga, di ba, may ganda. So I was thinking na baka, it might be the same team na naman, na ganda lang naman.
We experience that, yeah.
Right, na parang, baka mamaya, pasaway na naman, hindi na, she's just have a pretty face. So, yun, tas nung pagpasok ni Ward, shit, sumasayaw pala siya, ang ganda pala ng boses. So, it's really, right decision, bro.
No, I co-signed JV for that because we were starting the music label na eh. We were working on Telly, we were working on Jethro, we were working on, Ward was gonna be like,
I really didn't know na talented siya.
Nag-coaching pa kami, may parang, do you wanna be like a pussycat doll and sing?
Si Ward, si Ward.
Season 2, we sat down and we had like started to talk to producers.
Yeah, I was there nung nag-meeting kayo, pinapakanta mo siya ng
That's the only reason because I said, does she sing? I go, okay, I'll sign it.
Yeah, we just discovered that when she's already inside the house. Yeah. So, yun na nga, mabalik tayo dun sa recruitment na yun. There's a lot of notable people. Actually, lahat naman eh. Lahat naman talaga. But alam naman natin, dito, straight to the point tayo. Gusto nyong marinig yung mga pangalan ng mga idol nyo. Sige, pag-usapan natin. Diba? So, going back, the story was, first name was Angge, the last name was Ward.
Yeah.
Who would have thought that those would be
creating history? Yeah.
Creating history for the House of Cole, at least season 2, diba? So when Angge was soaring high early in the season, and I'm like, bro, galing mo. Kasi ako, marunong akong, this is for me, I would always want to be wrong because that makes me learn a lot of things. Na parang ang judgment ko siguro back then was the aesthetic outside.
Yeah.
And John saw something different because he did his research.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then it showed kasi ang naalala ko na ang takot ko noon nung sinabing POV yung content niya is another Francis. So that's why I was hesitant kasi sabi ko, John, in sa meeting natin sa LG group, John, paano gagawa ng content si Angge si Francis, hirap na hirap. And we all know at alam to ng lahat ng House of Collab kung ano yung content mo na original, medyo may hirapan ka kasi mapapasama ka sa mga dancer, singer. That's a challenge and who would have thought that pag humarap sa 247, which is another topic that I would like to open up, na that would be the darling of the crowd.
Of course, who would imagine dancer pala si Angge?
No. That's the talk effect.
Like, that's the talk effect.
Parang you go in and you come out a different person. Diba? Yeah.
So, yun na nga, entering that point, pag-usapan natin kung paano ba at ano ba yung nangyari. Bakit yung mga non-heavy hitters natin ng season 2, sila pa yung nag-shine ng sobra.
So, just going back, we have to set up the next discussion is, why did they get so big? And let's connect it to the 24/7.
Yeah, ito. Yeah. Yun talaga. But before we move on to that, sa aming mga viewers ngayon, kung umabot kayo sa minuto at segundo nitong video at ng podcast na to, maraming salamat sa suporta. Yes. Dahil maraming kayong makikita, maririnig, at first time na malalaman
first
dito
time.
Sa podcast ng The Guest List. Yes. So, saan nga ba kami mapapanood, John?
Fairfax Network Channel,
Facebook,
Instagram, and TikTok.
Yes.
Basically, in all platforms. Yes.
All platforms. So, and soon coming on Spotify. And of course, in every podcast, meron tayong disclaimer that opinions expressed by the guests and hosts are solely theirs and do not reflect the opinions and beliefs of the show, the channel, or its affiliates.
Yes.
So, on to the juicy parts tayo.
We
go back to our questions na tinanong natin nung, actually, hanggang ngayon, pinag-iisipan ko pa rin.
Ako rin.
Dahil hindi ko alam kung anong magiging basis, but maybe overall basis.
Ay, hindi pala ano, hindi pala favorite yung term natin.
Top three, whatever
criteria you have.
Most proud of.
Kung yun ang
criteria. Most proud of daddy.
If that's your criteria, then.
Diba? Yeah. So again, sa mga hindi pa nakakapanood, this is just our third episode.
Yeah.
At ang napag-uusapan pa lang namin is season 1 and season 2.
Yes.
So kung meron kayong hinahanap, bakit di namin binabanggit o kung anumang nasa utak nyo,
yeah,
eh sa susunod na episode, abangan nyo. Baka nandun na pag-usapan na namin yung mga idol nyo. Kasi yes, ano tayo eh. Alam mo naman. So, let's go to the juicy questions. Who is in the minds of Sir Jon, Sir Ryan, Sir JV is the top 3?
Season 2.
Okay, sinong gusto magsimula?
1, 2, 3?
1, 2, 3. Yeah.
So,
well, this is the joke became a reality. So yeah, of course I'll take credit for the. I'm very proud of Ange because I don't have stress from her.
Yes,
but she performs the way I want her to perform, and this is the magic. Me and Ange had a coaching session. Everything happened because we discussed it. We put it on paper and it happened. Maybe that's why I'm very proud of her. And most of them, she had the biggest ambition. She said, "John, I'm from Pampanga. The most I've earned is 500 pesos a month." Yeah. Now she's 19 years old and she's earning 7 figures a month. That's not favorite, but like I'm most proud of.
22
she came in 19 when we did the coaching session, diba? What do you want to do? Music? You want to TikTok? You want to work on? So, in my role in House of Collab, it's definitely crafting clarity on the career path. Let's say House of Collab, the magic happens after.
Yeah.
But the way she took upon the challenge and took advantage.
Yeah.
Fearless. I want to congratulate her boldness. Boldness, of course. And she did it.
Yeah.
So, if JV's happy with that. Just because for me, less problems. And that's the way it worked, So, top two.
Yeah.
Top two, just work, overall work ethic. If you want to build an agency and you want to build a company and you want people who can deliver, I'll pass the ball to Ward, number two. Like Jordan, LeBron, Kobe, I'll bring everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah. So regardless of who's who, I think Ward, she's a different animal.
Yeah.
Because she's the only one that can do a million diamonds a day in Kumu and not sleep till 4 a.m. I never saw anyone do that. I'm not sleeping 3 a.m., 3 a.m. Guys, ano pa?
Sabi parang Kobe. She's a killer.
Mamba mentality.
Like she came here to take the bag. Yeah, and I think, but the thing is, she didn't ask permission. She was, I'm going to get the bag. I'm going to make sure I have a fandom. Yeah. And she recreated herself.
Yeah.
And I think that's what shifted her. Like the future of content creators or earners or artists will not live in the ecosystem before. Well, I'm a TV, radio. I mean, they're there. But to craft your music career or blogging career or make money, you got to be hands-on. And I'll give it up to Ward. She's very hands-on.
Yeah.
As much as, whatever drama there is hard work behind that. And she deserves it.
Yeah.
And number three, shit, there's so many.
Jordan.
Oh, most proud of. Yeah. Most proud
of. Yeah, for sure. Whatever criteria fits.
Most proud of because our first single and our first artist was Telly.
Nice.
And I've never.
Oh, hindi.
So we had just context. We had Marcus Davis.
Yeah.
Yep.
He produced the song. We got a video done in a month and we got 300 million views on TikTok. And so far, no other artist has done that.
I'm
very proud of that.
I will back that up because when we do our presentations to investors and sponsors, I always am so proud when we dikit the photo and the streams, the number of hits, the number of TikTok videos, views of Mahika to a James Reed, to a Sarah Geronimo on TikTok.
Yeah.
So I'm very proud of Telly. Sana Telly, ituloy mo kung ano yung talagang path mo.
Yeah.
Do not get distracted by...
We decided like, let's do a music label around Telly.
Telly was the first mover for that. Ang galing, ang galing.
Yeah. And para sa akin, Telly is the most talented ng season 1.
She broke
she dances,
a viral song.
She sings
Yes. And sa mga alam natin ngayon hanggang season 4, we're trying to be another Telly or even more.
Yeah.
The difference of Telly is...
She's a writer.
That's talent wise. They can do it. But the difference of Telly is nakinig siya kay John.
Yeah.
Na sinabi ni John na parang Telly, the work is not done.
Yeah.
Hindi porket nakapag-shoot ka na, na may kanta ka na, the legwork happens when you finish it, the song, and then you talk to everybody and sell your song. Yeah. You promote your song.
Yeah.
Kung nagtataka kayo, bakit? Siguro maraming tao nagsasabi, mas marami yung fans si, ano, si, si Ward, for example. Pero bakit mas maraming streams yung kay Telly? Ang sasabihin ng mga tao is, eh kasi nauna yung kay Telly. Eh. But that's not the right answer. Yeah. The right answer is, Telly was so hardworking na lahat ng content creators, kinolab niya, lahat pinilit niya, and she really had a good relationship with everybody.
Actually, yeah. Iyon yung pinaka-main.
At, yeah, at kumalat ng kumalat, at hindi laba, at nagtulungan silang lahat for Telly to hit, to reach. I mean, malayo pa at marami pang kailangan gawin si Telly, pero she knows the recipe. All that Telly needs to do is to just continue.
That's right.
Actually, magandang point mo na yun. Aside, syempre, sa maganda yung song, parang lahat kasi is ano, okay yung relationship with Telly. So parang, alam yun, Telly doesn't have to push anyone na
just para
gumawa ng content na nang gumawa ng content for Mahika. Like, sila mismo yung gagawa ng content for Mahika because Jay just wanna do it for her.
Yeah. And it was a good song. It was a good trend. Yeah. You made it viral.
Yeah. Ano yung napaka-catchy rin. Di ba? Ang ganyan dali niyang gawa ng content talaga.
Yes, agree. So that's your top three?
Top three. Okay. Keep it easy and simple.
Mauna na ako sa top three ko kasi si Ryan mag-iisip pa to eh. So, ako, my top three is Complex. Since we're just talking about season 2.
Yeah.
My top one is Ward and Angge. Bakit dalawa? I feel like without each other back in season 2, they will not reach wherever they are today.
Yes.
True.
So kung tatanungin mo ako, they complemented each other and they're both my top one.
Mm-hmm.
Bakit? Napag-usapan na natin, the number shows itself na itong dalawang content creator na to, sinasabi ko sa inyo, they are very talented and they knew what they had to do back in season 2. That's why where they are today.
Yeah.
They were not afraid to show on 247. Dumating pa sa punto na yon na akala nila kaaway sila ng lahat ng content creators na nasa loob ng season 2, but they stood up. I've had countless meetings with the two of them back in Italy na I'm telling them na, guys, this is just part of the journey. And whatever comes, fame or success, also comes all the haters and the doubters, which is hindi man fully okay yung buong season 2, but it happened already. That was the peak of whatever tandem or partnership that was. So they are my top one. Yeah. So it's really the both of them. And I believe, because bakit sila, bakit sabihin, oh, si Sir JV, napaka ano naman, bakit hindi pa isang tao lang? Siyempre, alam kong gusto nyong marinig nyo galing sa akin kung sino ang top one ko, but hindi ko ibibigay sa inyo yon dahil, aminin na natin, because of the House of Collab season 2, the heights that they have reached wherever they are right now came from that moment, diba? So they are my top one. Now my top two is actually a solo person. My top two is Ana Coting. Why Ana Coting is my top two? Who would have thought, diba? Sabihin na natin, ito, may itsura to, yung Angge tsaka Ward eh. Di ko naman sinasabing walang itsura si... So, hindi ko sinasabing walang itsura si Coting. Pero,
Barbie ng
iba, gang. Iba yung features.
It's a stereotype.
Iba yung features. Yeah. But, let's face it, in entertainment, there are the different types of kung sino sikat. Ana, she did not let whatever it is that people might think of her, whether physically, whether how she talks, how she forma, she did not let that stop her. So my top two is really Ana Coting because she's very humble.
Yes.
And whatever it is na bash na makuha ni Ana Coting back in season 2 or even ngayon, she will just turn it into a content.
Yeah, yeah.
And will flip make it. Flip it.
And,
diba? And of course, why she deserves top two. Alam kong alam nyo na to. Karinderya.
Yes.
One word, karinderya.
Puro yes na lang ako, bro. Kasi napapayas na lang talaga ako.
Ana Coting started as a karinderya seller. So, hindi nakakaalam ng karinderya. It's, I'm sure, alam niyo yun. Nanonood kayo ng The House of Kula. Alam niyo yun. So, nagbibenta siya, nagbabantay siya ng ano, tindahan na nagtitinda ng ulam, extra rice, ganyan, lutong bahay.
Yeah.
Who would have thought that Ana Coting is now earning on the above six figures?
Yeah.
And not just Kumu, brand deals.
Brand deals, yes.
I think brand
Ana is one of the strongest content creator natin with brands. Baka hindi alam ni Jan to eh. Do you know, Jan, nung pumunta si Ana Coting, unang punta niya sa The House of Collab Mansion, she went there. Alam bang ang dala niya lang is 20 pesos? And then...
I did not know that. Parang humingi yata sa akin ng ano, ng something for... I'm not sure. Si Casey for...
Yeah, I remember that. She was, there's, so, we get it.
pa-uwi siya, bro. Kulang na yung pamasahin niya.
Screen test yan, screen test.
Hindi, you remember
yung collab, ano? Parang collab.
Oh, yung collab.
Colloquist
TV.
Colloquist TV.
Si Burger dito. Yung pamasahin niya, ang ginawa ko nun, inatid ko na lang siya. Paano? Pero, I mean, look at that story from, sabi mo, karindiriya, tindera na karindiriya. Only have this kind of money, punta sa mansion natin ng walang pera. And then look at her now. Yeah. Like, that is sobrang sarap nung sa feeling ng ganun na.
And, alam mo, why Anna deserves to be top 2 on my list is Anna listens.
Yep.
Yeah. Ang daling kausap ni Anna. Totoo. Ang daling kausap na pag sinabi mo na, Anna, kasi ito na eh, nung season 2, nagpapasukan na yung mga brand deal. And syempre, silang dalawa ni Russell, iba yung content nila eh. Compared to the other, everybody's dancing, singing, pa-cute. Silang dalawa,
bartagulan.
As in, bartagulan eh. I remember we had this conversation with the two of them, John, in Kumu Room na. Mm. Parang, maybe you need to change your... Kasi they're expressing na parang, sir, parang napapanghinaan kami na loob kasi yung iba may gifter, yung iba may brand deals na, kami wala pa, ganyan. Mm. We had a comment to them na parang, why not try changing switch it up your content. We're not saying na kalimutan mo yung content mo before.
Try something new.
Just try something new. Yeah. And Anna really listened. At every time minsan nag-uusap kami, lagi niyang sinasabi yan sa akin. That's why Anna for me deserves a top 2 dahil ito yung tinatawag na success story. This is really the proof of
concept.
There
should be a documentary on
Anna. I think I agree.
I think deserves a Netflix show. Like a more on, like the story.
Uy, Anna, kinikilig ka. Seryoso.
So when we say Netflix, I'm just saying we have a Netflix deal. Yeah. We're shooting September.
Yeah.
So whatever you promise season 1, we will have a movie.
Oh, kala nyo, nakalimutan na namin yun.
So we're shooting a Netflix plus we have other Netflix stuff.
Yes, yeah, yes. And Anna, I'm very proud. Yes. Very, I mean, I think all of us, even all your fans and the viewers, we're very proud of what Anna has reached today. And another reason, sige, dagdag ako ng dagdag. Yeah. Another reason why she's top 2 for me is nagkakaroon kami ng conversation ni Anna about money. That na Anna, parang ayoko lang na dumating sa punto na maging ano ka, careless ka sa pera mo. Dahil why am I so worried about you is because siya na mismo nagsabi, ngayon lang ako nakahawak ng 10,000 pesos. Mm. Eh ako ang style ko pa back then is wala pa silang mga bank account. Alam niyo ba lahat ng I think 80% of the house of Collab didn't have a bank account.
GCash lang.
GCash lang. Eh how can you give GCash back then? May limit lang,
yeah, diba? The banks were closed, we're
and
still
the banks
COVID.
Were closed kasi COVID.
Paano ka magdi-deposit ng million doon?
When I hand over 20,000, 30,000, 100,000 to Anna. Si Anna pa yung takot pang lumabas.
Naalala ko yan.
Takot pang pumunta sa, as in tumapak sa labas ng office ko dahil ngayon lang siya nakahawak na ganun. So why is she top 2 is natutuwa ako na nagtatanong siya sa akin what to do. Mm. Diba? And of course, yung glow up naman ni Anna Kuting ngayon. Sir. Ibang klase. Naglolokohan nga kami na parang sa dinami-dami ng mga babaeng content creators sa The House of Collab, ang pinakamaraming beses nagre-retouch eh si Anna Kuting. Diba?
Dati naalala ko, sabi ni Kuting wala siyang makeup. Ngayon meron na siyang makeup.
We gave her that feedback. We say, Anna, I think you can attract these brand deals. And he said, get a touch up, get sponsors.
Sunod-sunod. At ang pinakamaganda pa rito, sorry, hindi ako naubusan ng reason bakit siya top 2.
Keep it coming.
Deserve niya, deserve ko ting.
Si Anna, pag nabigyan ng brand deal, hindi basta-bastang nagsushoot.
Yes.
Nang basta lang. Yung yung parang, eh, sikat ako eh, kinuha nila ako. O, sasayaw-sayaw lang ako, tapos papakita ko yung produkto. Hindi ganun.
Yes.
Si Anna, pinagpapraktisan niya yan.
Yes.
At bago niya i-submit yung project
maayos.
Natin, maayos niya. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why Palawan, Motor Ace, keeps on renewing.
Mm-hmm.
Yun ang sinasabi ko na hindi porket sikat ka na, yung content mo pag may deliverable ka, kaya nga kayo may deliverables everyday. Yeah. Para masanay kayo na kapag may kumuhang brand sa inyo, eh gagalingan nyo. Hindi yung ngayon ka lang nakakuha ng brand, di mo alam kung anong gagawin mo. Bakit hindi mo alam?
Mm.
Kasi you don't submit your deliverables properly.
You're not getting the exposure.
Diba? You're not getting the exposure. Yeah. So Anna really listens and that's why she's really top 2 for me. Okay, so now, moving to the top 3. For my top 3, again, my top 3, top 1, 2, 3 is very complex. My top 3 is a duo again.
Mm-hmm.
And dito ko ipapasok ang Carlia. So Carlia, for those who don't know, a little backstory. Si Carl, you're the one who told me, and Carl shared this story before, na si Carl was about to quit social media.
Yeah. Aminado naman din siya.
Yeah. And then, parang when he went in, parang last, ano niya to. I'm sure Carlians know this, ganyan.
Last resort niya na.
Last resort.
Sabi niya after daw, kung hindi pa daw siya nakuha ng daw support or hindi siya naging successful, sabi niya parang willing na siyang
to
have a regular
life. I'm not saying, we're not saying it's a bad thing.
Yeah.
Pero sumugal, nag-restake si si Carl. And then on to Mahalia. Mahalia kasi is, I'm gonna say a bold phrase, wherein Mahalia is like a role model for the House of Collab. Para sa akin, alam naman natin si Carl is very playful, but Mahalia is kind of like a role model dahil wala kang maibabatong issue sa kanya. Mahalia knows how to handle her fans.
Never din siya nakisali. Yeah.
Never siyang nakisawsaw sa kung anumang issue. Unbothered. Yeah. That's my term for the
resilient. Resilient.
And resilient.
And she knows how to control her fans.
Yes. That's one thing na, alam mo, marami tayong nababasa sa social media na kung ano-ano. Mm. Nakesyo kung sino daw yung idol nyo, yun din daw yung fans. I mean, partly that can be true, partly that can be hearsay, but Mahalia, I don't see anything wrong with what she's doing the moment she stepped in the House of Collab.
We felt her presence.
Her presence. And si Mahalia, maybe because she's mature and at a young age, provider na siya for her family. Yung ganung mindset ng tao ang nagdadala sa'yo sa success.
Yeah.
So why Carlia and not just Mahalia or not just Carl is the two of them, even though they're the last people that entered season 4, they are a role model for a tandem or ano,
love that team.
Love team. And I'm very happy for them. There's so many reasons why they're my top three, not just on paper, on how much they earn. Mahalia closed a 1 million deal with True ID. Carl is getting these opportunities. And imagine, I always ask this, can you imagine yourself if you did not go inside the House of Kuya, diba? I mean, their love team, if not, can go the stretch. Yeah. The stretch.
And their fans are not just from Manila. I think they have fans from Visayas. Yeah.
Yes. That's and they have Mindanao also.
Mindanao, exactly.
And then one thing I really loved about their duo is, for my age, ito personal naman to, for my age, the way they vlog, is catches my niche. Kasi merong mga kinds ng YouTube vlogs na wala lang, yung pa-cute lang, ganun, yung parang update lang, POV, ganyan. Their vlog is curated na may hook. May hook, di ba? Na parang, why would I watch a 12-minute...
It's a strong reason to stay.
Dahil meron silang pakilig na medyo, somehow, medyo mature. Na ako, natutuwa ako whenever we watch it. It's, for me, I've said a lot for Mahalia, going back to Carl. Carl kasi, I saw the maturity. Carl was very playful.
Stepped up. It became more like a...
I'm not sure what Carl was doing before, but from what I heard, syempre iba naman si Carl before Ticho. Imagine mo na lang kung paano niya sinabi kay Mahalia na mahal niya si... Mahalia, parang, Mahalia, liga dito. Ngayon ko lang sasabihin to. I love you. Di ba yung mga ganung banat, mga anin eh. Sorry for the term, Carl, fuckboy. But I think they were the right match, and I hope that you guys go the strongest for the longest time.
Yes.
Saludo kami sa inyo. So they're my top three. Carl has become a mature person, and the playfulness of Mahalia is like, I feel like a perfect match.
Yeah.
So for me, they're my top three.
Yeah.
So Ryan, who's your top three from season 2?
Actually, itong top three ko, ano siya? More on duos and love teams. Kasi we know naman na season 2 is the birth of duos and love teams. Yun talaga yung, technically, that's our, parang yung naging niche natin di ba?
Yes.
Sa akin, ang top three natin, since this is season 2, I'll go for, hindi ko alam kung dapat tawag nila before is chatting. Charisse and Kuting. Season 2, si Charisse naman have a good performance yung season 2. Medyo nag-fall off lang siya nung season 3. Pero nung season 2, I believe
they had something
and season 2 I also believe, just like Carlia and Warden Angena, they really work as a duo talaga nung Charisse and Kuting.
That's the collab culture.
Yeah, yung talagang parang hinatak nila yung isa't isa kasi at that time si Charisse hindi siya makagawa nang wala si Kuting, si Kuting hindi makagawa nang walang Charisse. Parang talagang duo talaga sila, dikit talaga silang dalawa that time. And yun, sabi nga ni JB, lahat ng mga nakamit or naging achievements ni Kuting and also Charisse that time, ay happy rin ako nun kasi napagawa niya yung bahay nila.
Yes, I'm very proud of you, Russell. Kung minsan na madalas na panghihinaan ka ng love, Russell, that's something that you need to improve on, pero look at what you did. Yung message sa akin ni Russell was, Sir JV, after niya ma-send home ng season 3, couple of weeks after, parang sa message siya, Sir JV, very thankful ako, naalala ko kayo dahil nakikita ko yung fruits na idulot ng THOC dahil napakadami daw racket na ginawa ni Russell pero never niyang napagawa, which is yun naman yung gusto niya talaga ever since. So ako, ang sabi ko lang naman sa kanya, Russell, we're so proud of you. I mean, yes, you are right na ngayon lang natin nagawa to, but it is not entirely of THOC dahil nasa sa'yo rin yan kung paano mo ma-achieve yung goals mo.
Yes.
So, Chiteng is your number one?
No, number three. And then,
oh, 3-1.
And then si Kuting, we know the achievements of her. And yun nga, ngayon nakapagpadala siya. Laging sinasabi niya, nakapagpadala siya sa magulang niya, sa family niya ng pera. Yeah. And yung story nga na from Carinderia vendor to
50 pesos a day she's earning?
200 naman.
But left over. Parang after travel.
Yeah.
She goes after
travel. Ah, yung net niya.
Yeah, parang after travel, I get 550 pesos.
Pagkain pa, everything. Yeah, yeah.
So, whatever. Yeah.
And then now, siya kabilat ka na project. Imagine, you'll be a billboard. Nasa mapupunta ka sa billboard from Carinderia.
Oo nga pala, billboard.
Vendor to billboard, di ba?
Wow.
Imagine, tapos soon she'll be in movie for Netflix from a Carinderia vendor. Yeah. Di ba? Look at that success story, di ba? Yeah. So, sila yung top three ko. My top two would be Carlia. Yeah. Sabi mo nga, Mahalia is a very, is a good role model. Since season 2, parang until now, wala akong kilalang content creator na as disciplined kagaya ni Mahalia. Aside sa role model siya na yung mga binanggit nga natin kanina, she leads by example. Yep. Yung deliverables niya, like, complete.
Oh my God. Tama. Like, nakalimutan ko sabihin yan. Report cards ni Mahalia across the board.
Spotless.
Across the board.
She set the standard. I don't know any content creator. Kasi okay naman lahat. Pero yung as responsible, as disciplined, as Mahalia. Tapos, yung following niya na napakalaki, yung, I mean, kung pagsasama-samahin mo lahat yun, you really are a role model ka talaga.
Yeah, kudos. Diba?
And then, si Carl naman, ang ganda nung tandem nila. Kunwari, tatanungin ako, sino ito sa tingin mo mas magandang maging leader? Is it Mahalia or Carl? The way I see them, magkaiba sila.
Maganda. Actually, magandang ano yan.
Yeah.
That's a good topic. Kasi, go ahead, I have inputs on that also.
Magkaiba sila ng attack, but the way you see it, they can only lead kung magkasama sila dalawa. Why? Mahalia is a good role model. Gagawin niya lahat ng dapat gawin.
It's a general, co-general.
Yun yung dapat mong gawin. Pero ang nakita ko na medyo lack kay Mahalia is, so sobrang bait niya, I don't think yung kaya niyang, kunwari, pagsasabihan mo or pagkapagalitan mo, or kunwari, kung nasa position ko siya, I'm not sure kung kaya niyang sabihan or sigawan or kung ano man yung kasi sobrang bait niya.
It's a personality personality.
She leads by example.
Yun. Tama yan.
Leads by example.
Hindi na ako babatin later, pero sabihin ko lang, yung gusto ko sabihin, yung pagiging leader ni Mahalia is not by vocal.
Yes.
She shows it.
She just shows it na parang, I am setting the standard.
Yes. Which is, kung ano yung medyo luck kay Mahalia, yun yung I think kayang punan ni Carl. Kunwari sa concert. Si Carl, pag nagkamali ka, sasabihan ka talaga niya. Mali yan, ganito, ganito, ganito. Alam mo, yun kung ano yung
feedback.
Medyo kulang kay Mahalia, yun yung na, kung ano naman yung kulang kay Carl, yun yung ano ni Mahalia.
Counter.
So talagang perfect sila for each other.
So sinasabi mo, hindi ganun yung report cards ni Carl, ganun?
Hindi. No, not the report cards. But actually, hindi ko naman na-check yung report cards. So hindi ko alam kung ano. But I'm sure she's not as perfect as Mahalia. That's what I can say.
No, kasi you gotta understand, Mahalia, she's providing for a family.
Exactly.
The other guys in the house don't have bills to pay. So she's taking this very seriously.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's a difference.
They need to have that kind of mindset na, di ba?
This is all in for her. Right? This is her. This is her.
Yung wala nang safety net. This is it. Dapat, di ba?
Wala nang bukas-bukas.
Right. And my
bukas-bukas.
My top one is would be Ward and Angge. Let's be honest about
it. I think undisputed naman
yan. Undisputed yan.
Kahit anong tanungin nyo, pwede kayong mamili ng isa sa kanila, pero it's still there.
It's like light and darkness. You need both.
Yeah, you need both. It's undeniable.
It's undeniable.
we could be together.
Sabi nga natin, lagi nang sinasabi na season 2 daw is one of the, if not the most successful season, sabi nila. And I think one of the reason for that would be Warden Angge.
For sure.
Yung pinag-usapan pa lang natin kanina, yung nag-brainstorming kami, we planned kung ano yung gagawin, umaksyon agad sila.
Yeah.
Alam nila kung ano yung gagawin. And alam mo yun, parang sabi ko kanina, medyo na prejudge ko si Ward that time kasi akala ko yung she's just a pretty face. But then, not knowing she's one of the most talented content creators
we
have.
Yeah, I think Ward is a total performer.
Total performer. Ito, sinabi ko to sa iyo, James, nung
showstopper.
Showstopper.
Sinabi ko to sa iyo nung sabi ko, when it comes to sa concert, I have like mga siguro mga limang content creator na hindi ko kailangan makita yung performance or what, pero alam ko kahit hindi ko makita, kahit hindi ko marinig yan, I know at the concert alam ko na hindi papayag to na fail yung performance niya. Alam ko na kung kahit anong mangyari, it will be awesome performance.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They set the standard. Yeah.
Alam kong si Ward ganon. Hindi, yeah. Kahit anong mangyari dyan.
I wouldn't say perfectionist, but her excellence standard, yeah, which I love about her.
Yes.
You know, is high, you know.
Yeah. So, alam yun, kahit iwanan ko yun dyan, alam ko, bahala siya. Bahala sa buhay niya, gagawin
kasi,
yung...
Kasi Ward has the experience,
yes,
din kasi.
Yes, true. And the talent,
yes,
of course.
Yes, yes.
So top three is?
Very contrasting naman with Angge. Si Angge naman, minahal naman siya ng tao because of kung sino siya.
Totoo lang. Totoo lang, di ba?
Totoo siya, di ba?
Tsaka wala siyang ano, kahit i-meme siya or whatsoever, yes, she's owning up to it. Yes. And she's using it to get everybody's approval. Not, yeah, not approval, to get everybody's love.
Yeah.
Di ba?
So, ayun yung dalawa talaga. So for me, my top three, Cherise Cotting, top two is Carlia, top one is Warden Angge. And I don't think kung may tatanggalin ka sa tatlong, I don't think season 2 would be complete without any.
Yeah, it won't,
that was a perfect storm.
That's a perfect storm, that, yeah, season 2. Yeah, agree, agree.
So, yun,
so thank, yeah, thank you guys sa pag-share. But before we move on to our next topic, of course, if umabot kayo sa punto nito ng podcast namin nila John tsaka ni Ryan, maraming salamat sa patuloy na pagsuporta. At sana continue to watch us on Fairfax Network Channel sa Facebook, sa Instagram and TikTok. May mga snippets tayo doon. And of course, maraming salamat sa ating mga sponsors na patuloy na nagtitiwala. Bago natin pag-usapan itong next hot topic about season 2, sinasabi ko lang sa inyo na thank you so much for Home Suite. Available ang Home Suite sa ating mga leading furniture store. Pwede rin kayo mag-order online. And of course, sa Andok. Shoutout sa Andok.
Mav, thank you.
Mav, thank you so much, bro. We miss you. Kailan tayo ulit lalabas? Revel na, revel. Yes, and of course, Top O for supporting. And of course, MW Cash. Cha-ching! Let's wrap it up by answering another question.
Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Na sinagot natin nung season 1. Controversial ba to? Controversial ba to? Controversial. Sige, ano ba? Ang tanong, sino ba ang most challenging or if wag na tayong magpaligoy-ligoy pa, sino ang pinaka naging problematic season na content, yeah, creator nung season 2? Maririnig nyo yan dito sa podcast na to sa The Guest List. Tatanungin ang the people who are running the show kung sino sa tingin nyo ang pinaka problematic or challenging, if you wanna put it nicely, na content creator ng The House of Collab Season 2. Simulan natin kay Ryan Tanyada.
Ako,
una ka na kagad dahil huli ka kanina, una ka ngayon.
Okay, sige. Challenging. I would say, magulat kayo sa sagot ko.
Uy, sip talaga! Hindi ba, hindi ba?
Most challenging for me Season 2 is Maida Plus.
Wow, okay.
Gulat ka. Maida Plus, di ba?
Interesting.
Okay. Nanginayang ako kasi alam ko na si Maida Plus is deserve niyan maging season ender nung season 2. And I believe nung season 2, she could have reach more potentials and she could have gotten more opportunities in which she's having now, di ba? Pero iniisip ko nun, what if hindi lumabas si Maida Plus nung season 2? Baka she nakuha niya yung mga nakukuha niya ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
In an earlier pa, baka kung ano yung nakuha niya, it could have been bigger pa. Na-explain na naman natin kanina kung bakit siya lumabas, mm-hmm, ng season 2. So, sa akin, more on panghihinayang. Yun dun sa potential that she could have reached nung season 2 because lagi niyo sinasabi season 2 is the best season. What if she could have squeezed more doon sa season na yon, di ba? Yun yung sagot ko.
May okay class. Thank you. Sino muna sa atin dalawa? For me, the most problematic, or to put it nicely, the most challenging content creator for me ng season 2 is also my recruit.
Oy! Yes.
It was really Ward. Kung ang usapan natin ay season 2 lang, na-challenge ako kay Ward.
Mm-hmm.
Bakit ako na-challenge kay Ward? Kasi alam mo yung ano, yung usapan natin na kung bata mo yan, that's your problem.
Mm.
Ward got the success so fast that the challenge for me and management was how do you manage that success so fast to be able to retain it?
Mm.
And Ward is very vocal, direct to the point si Ward. Even up to me, kapag we have our coaching sessions with them, ato sabi ko sa inyo, medyo kasi minsan napapagod akong kausap si Ward, sa totoo lang. Ward, alam mo yan. Bakit ako napapagod? Kasi ako kasi medyo straight. Pareho kami straight to the point. Pero minsan kapag meron tayong pinaglalaban na punto, minsan talaga we still try our best to make it. That's my point. Parang ganun.
Eh si Ward, hindi papatalo.
Hindi naman sa hindi nagpapatalo si Ward. It's just
hindi,
that...
Ano siya masyad... tawag ito, hindi siya nagpapatalo. Kung ano yung, ano term to? Kung ano yung...
Oh, be careful, niya. Baka mas clean record tayo dito.
kung ano yung belief niya.
This is strong-willed.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Strong-willed.
Which is not negative.
We require that out of people.
Yeah, true. And
so challenging.
Challenging talaga. Sobrang na-challenge ako kay Ward kasi I want everyone to be so successful. Mm. And month one pa lang, silang dalawa ni Angge. And kasi ako, daanan ko lang si Angge. Si Angge kasi nung season 2, wala naman ako masyadong challenge or interaction kasi when I talk to them together. Mm. Pero during the times na kausap ko silang dalawa, ang mas maraming vino-voice out na concerns or questions was Ward.
I remember that.
Kasi si Angge, quiet lang siya noon. Yeah. And kung meron man, syempre meron din sinasabi si Angge. Pero kasi noong time na yun si Angge, kapag kaharap ko na silang dalawa, pag nagsalita na ako, si Angge oo na sa akin si Angge. Si Ward, umuoo rin naman siya, pero bago niya ma-express yung gusto niya sabihin.
Yeah.
Which is for me, not to compare their styles, but for me kasi, mas gusto ko na yung tao na, I'm not saying mas gusto ko yung kung ano yung style nila, but meron kasi mga tao na, who do you wanna deal with? Someone who's just quiet, or someone who will say everything to you, diba? It varies eh. So, during ng time na yun, syempre, busy rin tayo. Hindi naman, sa totoo lang, it's Femi's job to talk to them. It's not us eh. Pero nataon lang na shorthand tayo noon, konti pa Femi. So, yung time na yun, umaabot pa sa office ko talaga. Mm. So, for Ward, I was really challenged because, like for example, there was an issue before with Luis, Daddy Louie.
Oh yeah, alala ko yung meeting na.
It was four hours.
4 hours meeting.
And nagigets ko si Ward, nagigets ko si Luis, nagigets ko si Daddy Louie. Pero, syempre kasi, alam mo yun, fast forward, everything was okay naman na. It was just the heat of the moment na syempre lahat ng tao is fighting for their
spot
for their relevance. So Ward, talagang na-challenge ako sa'yo. Sobra.
I remember
dumating pa sa punto na
like, John, I spoke to Ward for 2 hours.
And hindi naman sa I don't want to have long conversations. I like conversations. It's just that back then fresh pa yung pagkakakilala at fresh pa yung learnings nila sa the House of Collab on how we run things and handle things. So, from then on, fast forward to the following season, iba naman na yung Ward na from season 2. And I'm just very happy na all those challenges and problems that we had before has gained into something better. Diba? So, again, we're just talking about season 2. Mm. When we go to season 3 and season 4, whatever it is, our conversations might change. Diba? So, that's my answer. The person that, the content creator that gave me the most challenge was really Ward.
Mm.
Yeah. So, John, who's the content creator for you?
For me, it was... I was only called in once to mediate something.
Yeah.
It was a mediation of Papileo, Yen,
Adin. Oo nga pala. Yeah. Meron pa nga
so,
pala.
I don't know why I was called there, but I took the opportunity to just fix
this. Yes, yes. Sa mga hindi nakakalam sa mga viewers natin, there was an issue before because Papileo, of course, was in a relationship with
Adin
Mizuki Baku. Yeah. Tapos nun, Yen was inside and Papileo was inside and there was like some CCTV footages and nagsasalitaan sila.
I think it was a drinking or something.
Yeah. We had a party that time.
Yeah. And like, of course, we expected.
Yeah.
So, I would say it was a bad thing, but the struggling thing was, you know, these kids, you know, they're the kids.
Mm.
You're a teenager. You're going to do things. And Leo's a guy. You know, I mean, I'm sure he talks to girls. I'm sure.
So
you're also famous.
Sino ano sa'yo? Si Leo? Adin, or
I had
si...
to fix all three. I think there was one time I brought him to the Kumu room. I think it was someone was having a mental breakdown or something about scratching or slicing.
Juicy! Yeah,
slicing.
Yeah.
May mga bagay na hindi kayo alam. Dito na i-splook. Yeah.
So there's already like, you know, signs of no. Then, you know, Casey called me to sit in the room. So I literally had to sit them down.
Yeah.
Like, fix this shit now.
Yeah.
You have to like literally make apologize and just drop this shit.
Suck it up.
Yeah, because this shit ain't working for me.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, I go, if you want to be friends, cool. If you want to hook up, fine.
Mm.
But don't fuck this shit up. Short, sweet. But the thing is, parang they're self-destructive when they're first young, emotional, jealous.
Yeah.
Lalo na lasing, diba? So I called everyone. Mm. I'm just like, stop this bullshit. Yeah. I mean, that was the highest episode one time. Yeah. Parang,
oh yes, kasi ano, andami ring ibang content creators outside the House of Collab that are chiming in.
Yeah. And the thing is, I don't want Leo to look like an asshole.
Yeah.
And I also want to, hey Leo, I know you're popular.
And our viewers that might not, it's not a good example for them.
There was like Twitter, oh,
issue pa dyan yung age ni, ano, ni Yen Lagman. Yes. Grabe yun.
So like, you know, everything was clear, but the thing is, we have to be very sensitive. We're in a reality show, but we have to check these people because someone needs to check them. Yeah. I just came to check in. Yeah. And at the end of the day, they hugged each other. Mm. They said, look, moving forward, we're all good, right?
Yeah.
That's it. We're all good.
Yeah.
So that's the most challenging because it was a life or death situation.
I agree. That can
top that. And KC, JV, when it goes to me, I'm like, you guys can't solve this, can't you?
Oh, parang kasi ano eh, for KC, syempre, mother figure. Tapos ako, parang, syempre, parang I always want to solve things internally. Pero it was way beyond me that time. Then, John, ko na bahala dito para neutral yung ano.
Yeah. I want to add something din doon. Kasi I remember during that time, na ito ni inisip ko sa iba ng mga tao that time, na parang during that time, that issue, parang the House of Collab pa rin yung sinisisi nila na tinotolerate yung ganito.
That's another topic, guys.
So ako naman, inisip ko, wait lang, kami ba naglapit doon sa... Kami ba nagsabi na may gawin sila dyan? Listen, or what? Or,
I mean, guys, the viewers can say anything naman. We're not trying to control you. You're entitled to your opinion. Yeah. That's what's up, diba? Again, just to remind you, this is a reality show. Yeah. Ryan has said this so many times on 247. Yes. Na guys, kung gusto nyo ng mga peke-peke, hindi para sa inyo ang The House of Collab. Kasi this is a reality show.
They want
a
happy story.
And at least you guys have learned something doon. Exactly. Hindi pala namin pwede dapat gawin yun.
Exactly.
Or, at the same time, guys, hindi nyo minsan nakikita kung how we discipline yung mga content creators namin behind the camera. It's just that sometimes, hindi naman namin kontrolado talaga kung anong gagawin nila. Kung
and also, I'll say, not all content creators are honest about everything. So they don't tell us everything.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, kung akala nyo, alam namin lahat, hindi rin. Yes. Siyempre,
they don't full disclosure.
Imagine 25, 26 content creators, nagiging 30 plus pa yan dahil sa mga new CC.
Yeah.
Hindi naman lahat alam ng management. Yeah. Depende rin naman. Of course, we have
some... backstory pa yan.
Yes, may backstory pa yan. And all of these people came from different places, different upbringings. Yeah. So imagine yung kung kayo nasasaktan or naapektuhan habang nanonood, paano pa kami na nandito na ipinagkatiwala ng mga magulang sa amin yung mga anak nila for a shot at fame and success. Yeah. It's really hard for us to manage everything. Yeah. Pero syempre, we're not asking for your understanding. We know what we're doing here. It's just that we're trying to explain and give light to the situation. Yeah. So, with that being said, before we wrap up this podcast, again, kung umabot ka sa punto ng video na to, thank you so much sa inyong patuloy na pagsuporta. Sana marami kayong natutunan. At yung mga gusto nyong marinig na pangalan, sana napasaya namin kayo. O kung na-bad trip man namin kayo, it is what it is. Diba? So,
kung nagustuhan nyo to, i-like nyo to.
Yeah, like,
kung hindi nyo nagustuhan to, i-share nyo to.
Diba? Oh, bash kayo muna. It still helps our algorithm.
So, it doesn't matter.
I-share nyo.
Unbothered kami.
We're not looking for your...
So, bigyan lang natin sila ng konting patikim kung anong aabangan sa next episode or sa next podcast ng The Guest List. Pinag-usapan natin Season 1. Pinag-usapan natin Season 2. Sino ang ating...
Top 3.
Sino ang ating...
Most challenging.
Ngayon, kung gusto nyong malaman sa Season 3 at Season 4.
Season 3 pa naman, ang sabi nila... sabi nila, Season 3 is the most toxic.
What?
Talaga? Sabi nila.
Bakit kaya? Sino kaya ang dahilan?
Pag-usapan natin yan.
Yan. Juicy yan.
Kung... Saka para malaman din natin sino ba yung nirecruit niya sa season 3.
Ayun. Oo. Nako. Actually, just to give a heads up for everybody, dumami na rin ang employees and staff ng The House of Collab as we go along each season.
Hindi na kami yung personal na nag-ano.
So, siguro come Season 3 and Season 4, medyo iba na yung dynamics kung sino ang who's. Kaninong bata ba to? Kaninong bata ba yan?
Tsaka ano, ang dami na rin namin kinukuha from audition na audition na tayo. Actually, from Season 2 and Season 1, audition din.
Exactly. So,
there's more options.
Yes, abangan nyo. Yung mga gusto nyong marinig na mapangalan sa Season 3 at Season 4, abangan
nyo
yan.
Sample.
Sino kailangan pag-usapan? Sino pwedeng pag-usapan?
Season 3.
Wait lang. Isa-isa natin yung mga naging issue ng Season 3. Sino ba nagkaroon ng issue ng Season 3?
Balita ako kasi nung Season 3, merong nagsabunutan.
Nagsabunutan. Meron pang issue ng gamitan.
Uy!
Naalala ko yun.
Ginagamit daw si...
diba?
Oy, oy.
Yes, that's enough.
Okay. Pero syempre, marami ring magandang bagay na nangyari yes. Tulad ng mga bagong love team. Ganyan, syempre. At meron din daw...
First time natin nag-concert sa Skydome.
Skydome. Yes. At syempre, meron ding mga nabuong grupo-grupo.
Yes, the clicks.
Diba? Kaya
the
nga, clicks. Kaya nga, bakit...
The factions.
Oo, bakit yung mga revelations next time na natin pag-usapan yan. So abangan nyo. Guys, maraming salamat sa pagnood ng aming podcast na The Guest List. You may watch us on
FAIRFAX Network Channel.
At mag-iiba na po kami ng damit.
Yes.
Ano namin?
We'll have sponsors by next time.
Oh, next time. Sponsors, baka naman.
Oh, guys, again, you can see us in FAIRFAX Network Channel. In what platforms, guys?
Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and soon on Spotify. So guys, kung na-enjoy nyo to, please like and share and comment kung meron kayong gustong i-guest. Ang pangalan nito, The Guest List. Pero syempre, nagsisimula pa lang tayo magkakaroon tayo ng maraming guest. At yes. Syempre, ako nga pala, si JV Advincula,
Ryan Tanyada,
John Herrera.
And this is The Guest List. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day.
Bye!